Hey, this is Garrett. Thanks for checking out this video. I want to talk real quick about getting sober without AA. So unfortunately for many people, one of the biggest obstacles to getting help with their problems and dealing with their alcoholism or their substance use disorder, whatever it is, one of the biggest problems is overcoming that obstacle of finding help. And sometimes a lot of people want to stay away from AA. They're not really sure what it's about. Maybe they just recognize a problem, but they're not sure if it's ready to take that next step. For a lot of people, they just don't know. They've got no experience and not really sure where to turn. So for many people, that can be a huge obstacle. Other people, they might have gone to a couple of meetings. They might have tried the 12-step program or 12-step program before, and something just didn't resonate with them, wasn't a good fit for them, wasn't something that they could apply at that time, or just, you know, maybe they couldn't find a good group to go to, and they couldn't find the meetings and the support that they really needed. Or just for any number of other reasons, there's some reason that AA wasn't a good solution for them. So it can be a wonderful solution for so many people. For a lot of people, it's not a great solution. It's not a great fit. But there are other alternatives, and I want to share some ideas for things that you can do or things that you can try if you yourself have found that AA is not a good fit for you. So before I talk about some other solutions, I want to share just some terminology. So there's a difference between, a lot of people go to AA because they want to get sober. There's a difference between the word sober or sobriety or abstinence and the word recovery. And everything that I do is helping people in their recovery, which is not really synonymous with sobriety. Some people might use it interchangeably, but there is a distinct difference. So sobriety or abstinence is the last time that you use whatever your drug of choice or your behavior of choice was to deal with, to cope with the pain that's in your life, the last time you exposed yourself to it. So the last day that you did that, that's when you entered your sobriety, and that's your, you know, your sober date. On the other hand, there's this term called recovery. And recovery is the day that you decided to make positive change in your life, the day that you decided to take control, the day that you decided that you wanted to stop creating the pain and the suffering in your life from those substances or those behaviors that you're doing and become a better version of yourself. You're ready to own up to some of the issues that you've had, some of your behaviors, and strive to become a better version of yourself. So some people, they find sobriety. Some people, they stop drinking or they stop using their drug of choice, but they never make that change of trying to work on and become a better version of themselves. Other people, they commit to recovery. They commit to that process of continuously improving and trying to become a better version of themselves, but they've relapsed a couple times along the way, or they've returned to old behaviors and old substances a couple times along the way. So for me, I focus on my work and attention on recovery, and the resources that I share are for people in recovery. Now, will that help somebody in sobriety? Absolutely. But just to explain the terminology or the vocabulary, if you will. So if not AA, if AA has not been a solution or it has not provided you the support or the change or the help that you've needed to make that positive change in your recovery or in your life, then the first thing to know is don't lose hope. I think too many people, they'll try AA, they'll go to a meeting, and it's not something that provides them the help or the support that they need, or for whatever reason, they can't even approach the AA model. They can't even get to a meeting. They can't even find anybody around them to talk to them about it, or just the guilt and the shame that they're still dealing with is too much for them to overcome that obstacle. Well, the first thing for you to know is don't lose hope. There are many other approaches to recovery that you can pursue to find the best fit for you and find what's right for your circumstances, so long as you are committed to making that change and you want to deal with some of the issues that have been in your life and become a better version of yourself. So first thing, don't lose hope. There are many other options. So one thing to recognize is, you know, the AA is probably one of the is the oldest and most well-known approach to recovery and dealing with our substance use issues or our behavioral issues, but it's certainly not the only. There's many other ones, and a quick Google search will turn up dozens. So for every person that has found themselves in a position where their life is defined by that substance use disorder or that alcoholism or that behavioral addiction, there's a different pathway. There's a different combination of life experiences and nature and nurture and traumas and pains that brought them to that place in their life. So what only makes sense is that there's not one way to get out of that hole. There's not one way to move beyond that pain and that trauma and live into someone's potential and find themselves thriving or flourishing in their recovery. So there are many different options. And if AA hasn't been a perfect fit for you, then know that there's other organizations that have been around for decades and helped many millions of people find and establish their recovery. There's many other approaches. So one of them is CR, so Celebrate Recovery. Very similar to the AA model, but it got some distinct differences, and it's a much better fit for some people. There's another program called Compassionate Recovery. Again, some similarities in the process and some very distinct differences that make it more appealing and more effective for some people. There's another program I'm familiar with that's pretty widely known. It's called Refuge Recovery. And this is a recovery program that's based on Buddhist principles and the philosophy of Buddhist living, which is talking about dealing with the pain and the suffering in our life, stop creating that suffering in our life and learning how to deal with and move through the suffering that we've created. And when you apply these all in the context of substance use disorder or addiction, it can be very effective for overcoming some of those challenges and establishing yourself in recovery. There's also another program I was recently introduced to called Y12SR, and it's a yoga-based recovery program. It's a 12-step program, but it's based on the fundamentals of yoga and a yoga practice. So mindfulness through movement, through dealing with the emotions that are in our body and overcoming them or dealing with or processing them in a more effective way so that we don't turn to those old ways of escaping, avoiding, and numbing. So that's something that's become very popular and helping a lot of people. For other people that don't want to pursue perfect sobriety or abstinence, there's also methods, the harm reduction or HAMS method. If you want to find out more about it, there's an acronym HAMS, which is harm reduction, abstinence, moderation, or safety. And these are just different ways, depending on whatever your version of recovery looks like, however you define that for you, however your journey or your path to becoming a better version of yourself is defined, there's some tools here and some ideas and some philosophy and approach that can help you pursue and realize that. So there's many different pathways. There's many different unique pathways. One other thing that I've recently read about, there was an NIH study that came out that reported that of all the people that find sobriety or all the people that find recovery and overcome some of their challenges or whatever that addiction was, their substance use disorder was they were facing, almost one third of them do it with no program at all. There's this term called spontaneous sobriety, and it's people that either some life event really woke them up and changed them. They just got to a place where they decided they were going to affect the change and they had the right things going in their life, the right combination of things, positivity, engagement, meaning, purpose, relationships, all these things working for them that put them in a place where they could just give up their behavior and just make that change. Sometimes a major life event will happen and it'll just kind of wake somebody up and their behaviors and their actions will change. And of those, nearly 70 or 80% of the people never relapse, they never go back. And that was a recovery that they found called spontaneous recovery or spontaneous sobriety. There's some more information about that in the NIH study. I'll try to find the link to it and put it down in the comments. But here, no matter how you're trying to pursue your recovery, no matter how you're trying to find that sobriety, that abstinence, or become that better version of yourself, there's critical elements that pathway needs to have. And all the ones that I mentioned, they have this, and there are many hundreds more also share these common components. One thing is, for you to even start on that path, you've got to recognize that there's something that you want to change. And if you don't want to change it, well then recovery or is kind of a moot point because there's nothing that you want to do differently. So not only do you have to recognize that there's something that's negatively affecting you or some area of your life that you should work on, but you also have to have that desire to make that change. You've got to have a desire to overcome that. If you don't have that, then any pathway or any resource or any tool is not going to be of any use to you because you've got no desire to use it. The next thing is, no matter what pathway, you need to have some kind of process for dealing with and processing the pain or the behaviors or that void inside of you. You have to have some way of looking at yourself, looking at your behaviors, looking at your beliefs, looking at your actions, looking at some of the traumas and processing some of the traumas and things that have happened in your life so that you can move through that and relieve a lot of that pressure. So many of us turn to these substances, turn to these behaviors because it's a way to deal with that void or that pain that's inside of us. Many people, they say that the first time that they felt good or they felt whole or they felt accepted was when they brought in this substance or this behavior. Well, if you back that up, then that begs the question, why was there so much pain? Why was there so much suffering to begin with that created that demand or that desire, that urge for something external to deal with that internal pain? Because when you can ask that question, we can start to investigate and process that, whether it's just behaviors or actions that somebody takes, or whether it's been some kind of developmental trauma or some kind of process or experiential trauma, or whether it's just a lack of feeling good enough or feeling accepted. Whatever it is, there's some kind of pain there. You need some kind of process to work through that and identify that and relieve some of that so that you don't have such a void or such a negative downward pull. Because if you never get rid of that, you might find yourself yourself in sobriety, you might find yourself in recovery, but it'll be a constant battle every single day trying to overcome that negative emotion, that negative pull from the inside. The next thing that is very common and that's extremely helpful is community, a sense of community. One of the greatest benefits that comes from AA is that sense of community that you find when you go and you connect with and you begin to interact with and exchange with other people that are like yourself going through a similar struggle. We all need some form of connection. It's one of the basic human needs for life. We all need to feel connected, loved, and accepted with some kind of tribe or some kind of community. And a lot of people find that for the first time, they don't feel like an outsider when they enter that room or when they go into an AA meeting. So whether it's AA or whether it's any of the other pathways to recovery, any other approaches, community is a very important element of that so that you no longer feel that you're different or feel like you're an outsider or feel like you're so unique that nobody's ever faced these traumas or these challenges before. You need to understand that you're not and find that community can be a great piece of it. One of the things that you'll get from that community, the next element that you need is accountability. You need somebody to, you know, to be accountable to. If you yourself was enough to make the change for it and you'd stick to it because you could hold yourself accountable, then you probably wouldn't need to go find some solution or some pathway to recovery. So having that accountability piece, whether it's somebody that's in that community or following that pathway to recovery that you're following or somebody else, you need that accountability to help you get through those sticking points, help you move past some of those obstacles and overcome some of those challenges. Another thing that you need to continue the process of recovery is a continuous effort, a continuous desire, a continuous effort. There's always things that we can do. There's always kind of bumps in the night. There's always things that come up. There's always new pains that come into our life. And if we don't continue that process of learning how to effectively deal with and move through those things, then we might be in a great place right now. But if we forget those tools, if we lose that connection, if we lose that desire, then our problem that went away temporarily very easily could come back and be a part of our life again. So if you don't continue that effort and continue that process, then that could be a reality for you. The last thing, and this is the most fundamental thing, I really started with this because this is the biggest thing that somebody needs to find their way into recovery, and that's hope. You have to have some element of hope that tomorrow could be different than today, could be different than yesterday. You've got to have some kind of hope that tomorrow you'll experience less pain and suffering than you did today, or that there's a better way to cope with, a better way to move through life, more joy, more fulfillment to get. You have to have some element of hope or you'll never buy into, you'll never go through the work, you'll never do some of the hard work that's required to become that better version of yourself and to find your relief and reprieve from that pain that's inside. So if you don't have that hope, then nothing else really matters. But if you've ever questioned that, if you've ever felt like you've lost hope, if you've ever tried something and it didn't stick or it didn't work or you just haven't been successful yet in your recovery, then please maintain that hope. Know that there's more options. Know that there's more resources. Know that there's more tools out there. And no matter what you think of yourself and no matter what other people are telling you, you have the capability. You're certainly worth it. You're certainly worth the effort. You have the capability to overcome the challenges with the right resources, with the right support. And you absolutely have the ability, the opportunity, and the likeliness to experience a better tomorrow if you're willing to make the effort. So please keep that hope. I'd love to hear your comments. Please drop some comments below. If there's anything else I can do to serve you, please reach out. Don't hesitate. And please share this video with somebody. I'm sure you know somebody that needs to hear this video, so please share it. Anyway, thanks for checking out this video, and I look forward to seeing you in future videos.